Hey everyone, this is Rima's Culinary Adventures and today we are making strawberry sorbet. Finally, it's summers and we have been blessed with the most delicious fruits. I mean, there's mangoes, berries, melons everywhere. And what's the best thing to do besides just eating them nice and chill? Making frozen desserts, of course. I mean, can you really go wrong with a nice frozen dessert? Sometimes that's all you need on a hot summer day. I mean, a refreshing lolly or a frozen cocktail. I mean, really, we can't go very wrong with that. So on today's frozen dessert menu, we have a nice sorbet. And while it's extraordinarily simple to make, you just need a handful of ingredients, but there are some key points to remember here. There's this very interesting article from Serious Eats on the science behind a good sorbet, and I shall link it down below in the description box. But in that article, they say that to get a good sorbet every single time, the amount of sugar in the sorbet should be about 20 to 30%. Of course, that also includes the sugar in the fruit itself. It's very important to get the sugar right. Sugar makes your sorbet lovely and sweet. It also affects the texture quite a bit. Add less and you'll end up with a granita instead of a sorbet. Add too much and your sorbet will never freeze and you'll end up with a semi-solid block of ice which will be more like a slushy. Not that there's anything wrong with a slushy. In fact, blended with some alcohol, you have the most wonderful frozen cocktail. So I always start with about 20% of sugar and then take it from there. So yeah, it's always worked for me and today I'm sharing this with you and I hope it works for you too. So give this recipe a go and I hope you like it.
First, we start with our sugar syrup. We add 150 grams of sugar in a saucepan and then pour in 100 grams of water. Then we place our saucepan on low to medium heat and stir gently to dissolve all the sugar. Patience is absolutely key here. You want to dissolve your sugar on low heat because if your heat's too high, the sugar may caramelize at the bottom and a lot of the water may evaporate. So keep stirring gently until all of the sugar is dissolved and then bring the syrup to a boil for about 30 seconds and then set it aside. The hardest part of our recipe is done. The sugar syrup is ready and left to cool while we prepare the rest of our ingredients. Aren't these berries absolutely beautiful? They are so fresh, they smell so good, and they're absolutely sweet. So we want to save as much of the fruit as we can, making sure that the berries are washed and properly drained. Pull the berries, ensuring that you only discard the green part and save as much of the flesh as you can. I find it quite easy to use the tip of a paring knife and peel off the green part and chop my berries into uniform pieces. Here I started out with 600 grams of strawberries and after hulling I was left with about 575 grams. That said, 550 to 600 grams of clean strawberries would be perfect in this recipe. Now, to the cooled sugar syrup, add in your lime or lemon zest, making sure that you avoid the white part because that will make your sorbet bitter. Be very gentle with your lemon, just grate once or twice. I like my sorbet quite zesty and therefore I use the zest of one whole lemon, but you can always use half and add more later. Now to your syrup, add in all of your strawberries and add in your lemon juice. I start with about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. This is a large lemon and I need about half of it. Also, don't be a donut like me and remove your seeds earlier so that you don't have to struggle and fish it out later on. With the seed out of the way, now I blend my berries until it's perfectly smooth. Using a food processor or a blender will be a lot neater than using a hand blender, but use whatever you have. You'll ultimately end up with the same results. Once your mixture is perfectly smooth, have a little taste and add more lime juice, lemon juice, or even a little bit more sugar, but make sure that you stir it in properly to dissolve it all. That said, I would advise you to not add any more than another tablespoon or 1.5 tablespoons of sugar here. If it ends up too sugary, then your sorbet will never freeze and it'll be like slushy. Therefore, it is very important that your proportion of sugar is just right. Now strain your sorbet mixture, making sure that you catch all of the lovely pulp and the juices and discard any of the seeds that are left behind. Now pour the mixture into a flat container or a baking dish and freeze overnight or until it's completely solid. I absolutely love these aluminium takeaway boxes for this purpose and I'll tell you why in a quick second. So my sorbet is nice and ready and here you can see that it's completely frozen but it's still soft enough to cut. This is what we want in a sorbet. Also, this is is where the aluminium foil comes handy. The sorbet comes out really easily in an aluminium foil, but use what you have. If it was a solid container, then you would have to put it in the fridge so that the sides can melt a little and then you can use it. Now chop the block into manageable pieces. Do you see the texture here? It is solid and yet it's not rock hard like ice. This is the consistency that you're looking for in a lolly as well. So if you want some lollies this summer, make this mixture and place it in lolly molds and then you have the perfect, most flavorful lollies for a hot summer day. Once done, place about 2/3 of it in a food processor. Add how much your food processor can handle. If you can add more, go for it. Otherwise, you can add less as well. Now pulse your frozen sorbet until they break down into smallish pieces. Ensure that your food processor doesn't run for a very long time. Otherwise, the sorbet at the bottom can melt away while the top still stays quite chunky. Add in the rest of your sorbet and blend away, pausing every so often until your sorbet is nice and smooth. Also, every few seconds, scrape the sides and the bottom of your food processor to ensure that everything blends uniformly and smoothly. A very time-sensitive process, you want to get this done as soon as possible and place it back in the freezer. This is what we are looking for. You can see that this is completely smooth. It's almost gone lighter in color because it's nicely aerated. So you can tell that this will be smooth and almost like ice cream. Once you've achieved this, you're good to go. Place it back in a freezer friendly container and freeze for another 2 to 3 hours and then you're ready to eat. Perfectly made sorbet is hard and not exactly scoopable when you just take it out of the freezer. So place it back in the fridge for about 15 to 20 minutes and then start scooping when it still resists a little bit but still yields a perfect scoop. When it's as easy as this, it's time to place it back in the freezer. Hope you make some and enjoy a double scoop shoved into one like me. Please like, subscribe and comment if you like this recipe. Thanks for watching and have a happy day.